Hello everyone, hope you clearly understand the format of revaluation account and partner's capital account which we discussed earlier. So today we will solve another sums based on admission of a partner. Look at the sums. A, B and C are partners sharing profit and losses in the ratio 2:3:5. On 31st March 2017, their balance sheet was as follow. So in this sums, there are three partners A, B and C who share their profit and losses in the ratio 2:3:5. As per 31st March 2017, their capital balance stood as 18,000, 22,000 and 26,000. Creditor balance is 32,000 and profit and loss account given as 7,000. Now look at the asset side. Goodwill is 10,000, machinery is 17,000, furniture 14,000, investment 16,000, stock value is 22,000, debtor is 21,000 and cash balance is 5,000. Total of balance sheet is 1,05,000. Now they admitted D into the partnership firm from 1st April 2017 for 1/6 share for the future profit of the firm. So D is admitted as a new partner for 1/6 share. Now look at the adjustment. Stock is revalued at ₹24,000. Previous balance of stock is 22,000, so it is increased by ₹2,000. Next is furniture, investment and machinery to be depreciated by 15%. Here the value of furniture, investment and machinery is decreased by 15%. Next is outstanding rent amounted to ₹900. Outstanding rent is the liability for the firm, so it increases liability and showed in the debit side of revaluation account. Next is prepaid salary ₹400. Prepaid salary means asset increases, so it shows in the credit side of revaluation account. Next is D brings ₹16,000 as his capital and ₹3,000 for goodwill in cash. The goodwill given in the adjustment and the goodwill given in the balance sheet is different. Goodwill given in the balance sheet is distributed among the old partner in old profit sharing ratio, and the goodwill given in the adjustment will distributed among the old partner in their sacrificing ratio. So let's start with the sums in the books of the firm revaluation account. First, stock is increased by ₹2,000. So we write in the credit side of revaluation account by stock account 2,000. Next, the value of furniture, investment and machinery is decreased by 15%. So 15% of 14,000 is 2,100. We write it in the debit side of revaluation account. 15% of 16,000 is 2,400. Again, debit side of revaluation account. And 15% of 17,000 is 2,550. We again write it in the debit side of revaluation account. Next is outstanding rent. So here liability increases. So we write it in the debit side of revaluation account. Next, prepaid salary, that is the asset. So it increases. We write it in the credit side of revaluation account. After that, as we see, by partner's capital account is written in the credit side of revaluation account. That means it's a revaluation loss, because debit side of revaluation account is more than credit side of revaluation account. So we write it by partner's capital account and divide it in the old profit sharing ratio, that is 2:3:5. So the balance is 5,550. We divide it in the ratio 2:3:5. So share of A is 1110, share of B is 1665 and share of C is 2775. This balance is transferred to partner's capital account. Now we prepare partner's capital account. First, look at the credit side. By balance BD, the balance given in the balance sheet, that is balance of A, B and C, 18,000, 22,000 and 26,000. Next is by cash account, the cash bought by the new partner D, that is 16,000. One more account is given in the liability side of the balance sheet, that is profit and loss account. Profit and loss account is divisible among old partner in old profit sharing ratio. So it is 7,000, which is divided in the ratio 2:3:5. In A's account it is 1400, in B's account it is 2100, in C's account it is 3500. Now we divide goodwill bought by the new partner among the old partner in old profit sharing ratio. Whenever a partners enter for a part of share, then old profit sharing ratio and sacrificing ratio will remain same. So we divide goodwill in the ratio 2:3:5, that is 600, 900 and 1500. Now look at the debit side of partner's capital account. First we write two revaluation loss, which is revaluation loss. In A's account it is 1110, in B's account it is 1665, in C's account it is 2775. After that, two goodwill account. This goodwill represent the goodwill present in the balance sheet, that is 10,000. We divide it in the old profit sharing ratio, that is 2:3:5. In A's account 2000, B's account 3000 and in C's account it is 5000. After that we sum up credit side and subtract debit side from it. We got the balance of capital, that is in A's account 16,890, B's account 20,335, C's account 23,225 and in D's account it is 16,000. Now we will prepare balance sheet. First look at the liability side. In liability side we simply transfer the capital balance from partner's capital account. That is, capital of A is 16,890, B is 20,335, C's capital balance is 23,225 and D's capital balance is 16,000. Creditor will remain same as previous balance sheet, 32,000, because there is no adjustment. And one more thing add here, that is outstanding rent, which is 900. Now look at the asset side. Machinery value is decreased by 15%. So 17,000 minus 15%, that is 2550. Final balance is 14,450. Similarly, furniture is 11,900 and investment is 13,600. After that, stock is increased by rupees 2000 and previous balance was 22,000. So its balance is 24,000. After that, debtors account will remain same because there is no adjustment, but cash balance will increase. Now look at the cash account. Previous balance of cash is 5,000 and cash bought by the new partner is 16,000 and premium of goodwill bought by the new partner is 3,000. So total cash balance is 24,000. One more thing add in the balance sheet, that is prepaid salary rupees 400, which is given in the adjustment. Total of balance sheet is 1,09,350. So here the sums ends. So two things to remember in this sums: old profit sharing ratio and sacrificing ratio is same here. I didn't calculate it because when partners enter for a particular share, sacrificing ratio will remain same as old profit sharing ratio. If you want to calculate it and show it in the working note of the sums. Secondly, whenever goodwill given in the balance sheet, it will be distributed among the old partners in old profit sharing ratio and show it in the debit side of partner's capital account.
If you like this video, please click subscribe to watch more such videos. Thanks for watching.